Helen Keller. She in the dark found light, brighter than many ever see. She within herself found loveliness through the soul's own mastery. And now the world receives from her dower the message of the strength of inner power. Danse Africaine. The low beating of the tom-toms, the slow beating of the tom-toms. Low, slow, slow, low, stirs your blood. Dance. A night-veiled girl whirls softly into a circle of light. Whirls softly, slowly, like a wisp of smoke around the fire. And the tom-toms beat, and the tom-toms beat, and the low beating of the tom-toms stirs your blood.
Thank you.
From the Big Sea, a memoir by Langston. One night, there was a terrific fight in the Grand Duke. It began like this. A little French danseuse named Annette was going to have a child. Still, to make a living, she had to come to work every night, dance with the patrons, and drink as much champagne as she could in order to get her commission. But she was not well, and she shouldn't have been there. Of course, if she had had any other way of making a living, she wouldn't have been there. Feeling badly, no doubt, Annette began to be very spiteful to those clients who didn't think they could afford another bottle of champagne. So one night, the owner of the place asked her not to come back anymore. He called an attendant to eject her. Annette would not go. The attendant laid hands on her and pushed her, struggling in her satin evening gown, toward the door. As she passed the last table, Annette seized a patron's champagne bucket, ice bottle and all, and flung it straight at the proprietor at his cash desk behind the bar. Whereupon, the attendant slapped Annette to the floor with one blow of his hand. Then it was that Florence, the famous entertainer, that same Florence who snubbed millionaires nightly, arose from her table near the orchestra to defend the poor little French danseuse in her troubles. Florence wore an evening gown of gold and a spray of orchids in her hair. She swept across the floor like a handsome tigress, blocking the path of the waiters, who at the bidding of the management rushed to eject the little danseuse. Florence said, "Don't touch that woman. She's a woman, and I'm a woman, and can't nobody hit a woman in any place where I work. Don't put your hands on that woman." By that time, the little danseuse had risen from the floor and seized another ice bucket, which she sent whirling into space. Customers dodged behind tables. The orchestra struck up "Tuck Me to Sleep in My Old Kentucky Home" to drown out the noise. A waiter did lay hands on the danseuse, but Florence laid hands on the waiter. Then the Negro manager laid hands on Florence, and a battle royal began between the women and those who sided with the women, and the management and those who sided with the men. In time of silver rain, in time of silver rain, the earth puts forth new life again. Green grasses grow and flowers lift their heads and over all the plain the wonder spreads of life, of life, of life. In time of silver rain, the butterflies lift silken wings to catch a rainbow cry, and trees put forth new leaves to sing in joy beneath the sky, as down the roadway passing boys and girls go singing too, in time of silver rain, when spring and life are new.
Thank you.
jazz act in a Parisian cabaret. Play that thing, jazz band. Play it for the lords and ladies, for the dukes and counts, for the whores and gigolos, for the American millionaires, and the school teachers out for a spree. Play it, jazz band. You know that tune that laughs and cries at the same time. You know it. May I? May we? Mein Gott! Perece una rumba! Play it, jazz band. You've got 7 languages to speak in, and then some, even if you do come from Georgia. Can I go home with you, sweetie?
Thank you.
Summer night. The sounds of the Harlem night drop one by one into stillness. The last player piano is closed. The last Victrola ceases with the jazz boy blues. The last crying baby sleeps, and the night becomes still as a whispering heartbeat. I toss without rest in the darkness, weary as the tired night. My soul empty as the silence, empty with a vague, aching emptiness, desiring, needing someone, something. I toss without rest in the darkness until the new dawn, wan and pale, descends like a white mist into the courtyard.